We're hearing now from three former presidents, former President Bill Clinton and his wife Hillary Clinton, saying Senator John McCain believed that every citizen has a responsibility to make something of the freedoms given by our Constitution. And from his heroic service in the Navy to his 35 years in Congress, he lived by his creed every day. He was a skilled, tough politician, as well as a trusted colleague alongside whom Hillary was honored to serve in the Senate. He frequently put partisanship aside to do what he thought was best for the country and was never afraid to break the mold if it was the right thing to do. I will always be especially grateful for his leadership and our successful efforts to normalize relations with Vietnam. Our thoughts and prayers are with his wife, Cindy, his mother, Roberta, his children, and his entire family. And he mentions normalizing relations with Vietnam, and that was in the 90s as part of the Senate Select Committee on POW-MIA Affairs. McCain, he worked with Democrats on normalizing relations and increasing trade with Vietnam. So one of his many, many marks and that he leaves behind in history, as we were just speaking with former Senator Kyle about how he really made a mark when it came to foreign relations and national security. That's where his passion was. That's where he really was courageous in making things happen. Let me read you what former President George W. Bush is saying, also sharing his condolences, saying some lives are so vivid, it is difficult to imagine them ended. Some voices are so vibrant, it is hard to think of them stilled. John McCain was a man of deep conviction and a patriot of the highest order. He was a public servant in the finest traditions of our country. And to me, he was a friend whom I will deeply miss. Laura and I send our heartfelt sympathies to Cindy and the entire McCain family, and our thanks to God for the life of John McCain and former President. Jimmy Carter also saying this: John McCain was a man of honor, a true patriot in the best sense of the world, of the word. Americans will be forever grateful for his heroic military service and for his steadfast integrity as a member of the United States Senate. Rosalind and I extend our sincere condolences to Senator McCain's family and to the people of Arizona, whom he represented so forthrightly for so many years. And here you see the sun setting over Sedona, Arizona. I want to go back to Dana Bash. John McCain, he never won the presidency, Dana, but he also never gave up his fight for this country, and he earned the respect of all of these presidents who call him his friend.
That's right. I'm mesmerized by what we're seeing on the screen, Anna. I'm sure you are too. I mean, that's almost, it's otherworldly what we're looking at with that sunset in his beloved place. It's hard to really find words to describe it. And to describe the man, as you said, he didn't make it to the highest office in the land. He didn't make it to the White House. But the fact that we are hearing from two men who kept him from the presidency, George W. Bush in the primaries, the Republican primaries back in 2000, and of course, President Barack Obama, who beat him in the general election in 2008, which with such long and heartfelt statements tells you so much about this man, because they were his competitors, but they were not his adversaries, and they were certainly not his enemies. And I can just tell you that I was at John McCain's concession speech there in Arizona, in Phoenix, not far away, where he talked about the fact that the country needed to unite behind Barack Obama. And I've heard since that people, when John McCain would visit them around the world, they would quote that speech back to him, Anna, because it meant so much about the nature of our democracy. And that is what John McCain always strove for. His mantra was striving for a cause greater than one's own self. And he lived that, and he spoke that, and he acted that way until this day when he passed.
As we continue to look at these pictures, I just want to read you a couple of quotes. John McCain's own words. When he was talking about his diagnosis in his interview with Jake Tapper, he said, "I'm very happy with my life. I'm very happy with what I have been able to do. And there's two ways of looking at things. And one of them is to celebrate. I'm able to celebrate a wonderful life, and I will be grateful for additional time that I have. And that was last September. He went on to live another year, even though his prognosis was not good. He knew it, but he lived his life fully to the very last day. As we look at the White House there, flag tonight at half staff. He talked about how he wanted to be remembered, and this is what he said. Quote, he served his country, and not always right, made a lot of mistakes, made a lot of errors, but served his country. And I hope we could add honorably. I don't think there's anybody who could say John McCain did not serve honorably. He was an honorable man, Dana.
Duty, honor, country. That was John McCain. And I will just say that Meghan McCain's full statement will take your breath away for anybody who, everybody should read it. And I'll just read you part as we're looking at this fiery, fiery sky. Meghan McCain wrote in part, he was a great fire who burned bright, and we lived in his light and warmth for so very long. We know that his flame lives on in each of us. And you can almost see that in the sky there in Arizona, Anna.
All right, Dana Bash, thank you. Just to recap our breaking news, Senator John McCain, an American hero, dead at age 81, surrounded by his family and his loved ones at his ranch in Sedona, Arizona.